Good evening, YouTube. Lorenzo here. Going to comment 1v1 versus Idea Milo. Actually, I played him. I don't know, maybe a week ago or something. You can see the previous battle. Also recorded and commented on my my channel. I hope I fixed my mic, because my mic was making very poor sound because of poor settings, and I changed that, so hopefully now the mic is much better, and should be giving a much better sound, like it was in the past. But I had some problems with my PC and had to, basically, maybe the settings were lost in between. What do we have? We are playing on this map. He has the bow map, bow dojo here. I have the sword, which can be an advantage in particular because he played against me, you know, sword -2, which remember Fugu Cook, yeah. And my Nodachi level 2 are only 16 attack now, so that's not very good. I see, you know, clearly he wanted to charge here. I have two Yarisam Vanilla here to support my my matchlock, which are with extended range, so give me an advantage when his matchlocks are without any extended range. However, this player is really good at moves and basically wrapping you up, and you'll see that similarly in the battle I commented. That I was mentioning at the beginning. Here he has a bow cave. He's supported, actually, you know, it's not like mine where I have all my army here. He has divided his army in two, and good, I'm taking advantage of the ridge here to try to get some good shot with my bow cave. Already 13 kills, but you know, he's getting here you know, some and he has a bow cave, but I noticed it was level 2 when mine is level 5, so I may have a slight advantage, but in terms of reload, things like that. I see that he's moving his cave here. He wants to get up the ridge for sure. He's grouping also some spears on this side. I'm dispatching one of the Yari in order to support this unit in case of. But I have to fight over this front, and I captured the sword dojo, which is nice. He captured the bow dojo, but he is going to uncapture this one if I don't do anything. So what I did is repositioned one of my matchlock, but not good enough. I cannot shoot at them. That's really a pain. I'm trying to use the forest now, actually. I thought, okay, why stay in the open when I can use the forest? So I positioned this Nagi attendant here to help with the cave. I dispatched one of the cave here. I'm charging. He's pulling back nicely. Maybe he wants to bring me into his spears. I don't know. But that was one tactic. I'm still trying to shoot whatever I can, you know, at this. But I'm getting shot myself. So you know, by this. Damn bow cave, so I put it back in the woods, you know, it's better like that. He's pulling back, not sure why. Maybe he saw that I was reinforcing. Indeed, I was reinforcing against this spike, I was reinforcing with another chi, but you know, my frontier is getting depleted, and he's moving up with this one, and I cannot basically commit any of the cave, otherwise I'm going to get shot to death. So I have the ridge advantage here. He cannot shoot at me unless he goes, you know, more up the hill. So I'm going to dispatch this one, trying to reposition. I have the range advantage, but okay. So it's really, you know, very tactical battle. I'm still having this dojo, but I think it's not for long. And he's, you know, he's also repositioning here. He gets some shot. I don't know, he was shooting at my chain, maybe, or no, to this Yari-sam. Am I positioning this one? I don't know, apparently not in range. Too bad. So he's disorganizing this front for sure. You know, this one, for example, is not protected anymore. Maybe he sees that, I don't know. But I'm pulling back here with my cav because I see some spears and some monk. I decide to send my light cav, but I see that he stops immediately, so I stop myself, I retreat. Here I see as brought his cav up the hill. I'm going to charge and dispatch my Yari, which was which I brought for that purpose. I'm going to dispatch another Yari, and I'm going to dispatch my Chen, which has some good returner with the Meppo mask, so could take out this cav pretty quickly. Here I'm going to pull back these units, otherwise they're going to be dead. I'm trying to stop this cav here. Yeah, I'm dispatching one or two. This one I'm totally going to lose. I don't know, maybe it was on the attack order on some sort, I don't know. But that's really stupid. I'm taking out this cav, I'm going to almost lose this matchlock as well. That's really well done. I'm counter charging with this two cav that I took out. I'm also unclicking my bow cav. I really want to take out this cav so that I can retreat and save whatever I can of this part of our army. Here I'm going to have the downhill advantage maybe, but still I'm a bit slow. He's really well good at microing. Here I'm going to target this matchlock, get rid of that. I have two calves. I see that his Chen is also in stand and fight, so that's a good target now. I need to finish off this one, pull back, and then maybe use this Yari to soften. I'm going to redispatch these two cav towards the Chen. I'm going to do an hammer and anvil here, although it's downhill, but it's a pretty good position. Well, I'm getting support from a Yari here, so let's see the charges is actually not great because I'm losing men. That was not great. Here he had spears, so took out one of my cav. I was able still to finish off this this matchlock. This one I'm going to pull back. I think I need to take out this this cav. I'm still holding. I have the downhill charge here. What do I do there? I think I'm trying to escape with this cav. Not sure. Here I really want to take out the Chen. What I'm going to do is again do a hammer and anvil on this unit so that to finish that off, I think, and free up all this. I don't know, it's chasing this cav. This one I'm chasing, charging this Nagi attendant in the back, then also charging with my Gen. I think enough to root this unit, and then dispatching my Nodachi, just left over my Nodachi, onto his Gen, because I want to take out this Gen here. I made a mistake because this bow was targeting this one, so that and I reposition. Well done from him. Really not as good as two macro, as good as he is, but and still not able to take out this damn Gen. That was a super heavy resistant Gen. He has one cav left. That's a bow cav. Damn, that's a bow cav. I thought it was a normal cav. I didn't see that actually. I have a Yari, so I'm quite confident I can make it. I'm going to send my Gen with Meppo mask. Here I'm going to try to take out this cav with my Yari, while my Gen is making the job, plus this one that actually is up the hill, but actually is here. So pulling back my Gen, trying to, this one rooted, so I have to come back actually and make sure that this is over. Taking out this Boca, which could be very dangerous for the end of the game, and that's it. He lost his Gen. I have mine, which is a bow Gen, so can be useful, although I have only 8 men left, but almost full load of ammo, and this one is coming back. Hopefully, I was trying to run after it so that you know, it comes back from routing. I'm pulling back this one out of range of this matchlock. I have a ridge here. I'm going to start shooting with my gen using arrows. This unit is routing already, and then I'm continuing. We can see I'm shooting with arrows. So he has only two units left now. I have the ridge, you know, that protects me, kind of. He has now the two dojos, so I'm going to change tactic because I see he's retreating. But that's a Nagi lieutenant, so not very strong. I have actually two Yarisam, although depleted, but this gen, you know, I'm dispatching so that to be able to flank, and he decided that actually, you know, I was winning the battle because I was going actually to undo the and capture the dojos and then use my gen to bit by bit take out his matchlock, and then that would be over. So tough game. He's really good at surrounding and you know, positioning his his troops. That's what he did last time, very well as well. It was really like a trap. So really well played from Idea Milo. And again, I was lucky to win, I think. Let's see the stats. Maybe first, you know, he had a bigger army, so probably less vetted than mine. Was able actually to do more kills. Let's see where that was. My Yari really did great. These two vanilla Yari against, you know, probably thanks to the ill advantage against also strong cav. And then one Nodachi, my Bokav, disappointing still. My gen is certainly disappointing. I used it more to charge than to, you know, using arrows. My two Cav, and here, you know, all the units that really got crushed and overwhelmed by his tactic. Why not one Nodachi? Both of my matchlocks, well, despite the rage advantage, but it's very elite, so it was maybe a bit difficult to use this advantage. And on his side, great use of his bow cav, quite amazing. But he has only two units above 100. We can see actually at he's a Suwardashigaru, that's why he had much more men. And that's about it. You know, I wasn't really able to use his matchlock as well, but you know, the fans were not as much invested on his side on these units when it was on my side. So two units above 100 when I have actually five. So that was enough actually to turn the game. So hope you enjoy. Very nice battle, well played by Milo, and see you next time. Bye.